Hey, how you doing? Anthony Ferraro here, Create Sci-Fi. Welcome to the third video in my DIY series, How to Create a Sci-Fi Short. This week, I want to talk about casting. Casting is crucial, and it's very important that you get this step right. It can be a challenge on a low budget, but I'm going to go over some steps with you that'll help you achieve that. Now, I'm going to beg you that you don't just cast your friends. Make the effort to get a working actor or somebody who's aspiring to be an actor. It'll make a huge difference. So I'm gonna go through that process with you right here. All right, so let's get started. The first thing we wanna do is create our casting call. What you wanna do with this is you wanna get actors excited about the project. You need to communicate very clearly the details of the production, when you're gonna be shooting it. Are you an independent company? Is it just you, union or non-union? And you wanna give the actors a glimpse into who you are. If you have a Facebook page or even a website or something to make you a real person. Don't worry if this is your first project, you're just gonna say, this is my first project. A real important thing is a synopsis of the project, just a quick log line, and then the character breakdowns. All right, well, once you've organized all that information, we're gonna use that to create our casting notice. Now, if you live in a small town or someplace where there's not a vibrant creative community, you can just use that information to create a flyer, post it in a coffee shop or someplace they show independent films or a college or a community theater. The best way to do it is online. I live in Los Angeles, so there's a few great resources to do that. So I'm gonna go over that here. And also, if you live in a small town, you can also do it on Craigslist, which I'll go over as well. Backstage is probably the best DIY non-union resource. So if you're near one of these cities, I would go ahead and take that information and we're just gonna copy it into a casting notice on this site, which is nice because you can do everything through the site and do that. If you're not, you could just use Craigslist. Now, there is some creepy stuff on Craigslist, so that's why it's even more important to be transparent in your Craigslist postings, but I've gotten great responses from it before. And then go ahead and post that information into Craigslist. All right, now, prior to posting that ad, you need to have secured some sort of location to hold the audition. Theater is ideal. A dedicated auditioning space is perfect. If you live in a major city, those will be available. Otherwise, an office after hours is great, a conference room. I've actually used a bar during the daytime before they open. You just need a space where you can gather 10 or 12 people to wait and then have another space where they can go and audition. Also, you're gonna need somebody to help you out. You'll need a sign-up sheet where they can put their names, emails, and phone numbers, just so you have that in one location. And then the other person can send them in and out. And you're gonna have to film it. I just use a phone or a tablet. Just make sure it's on a tripod. It doesn't matter the quality. You just wanna be able to review it later. Sometimes the next day or later that night is best. And then the casting begins. Now you're going to have a lot of patience. You're gonna need to see a lot of people to find your actors, especially in a low budget DIY situation. So what you're doing is you're finding people who are just starting out like yourself, or people like yourself that are willing to create on a low budget. And you're just gonna have to go through a lot of people till you find the right one. And eventually you will. I've never not found a person. Now once you've seen everybody, you're gonna have to pick some people for the callback. I try to get 3 to 6 people. And also, I take advantage of this time to call in people that I've worked with before that I think might be good for the part. I just wanna hear them say these words. It might be different than the last thing that we worked on together. And it's just a professional courtesy to say, hey, you know, skip the line. I just wanna see you for this. Another thing that's helpful is when you're auditioning, if somebody appears to be a good candidate for the role, it's always good to ask them to do something totally different than what they just did. You're just trying to see how they take direction and how they're able to adjust. If they're able to just do it, no problem, then you know that's a very strong candidate. All right, so the reality is you need to keep in mind that you're gonna need a second or third choice. The person that's perfect for the role might not be available, or they might not be interested. It happens. Also, worst case scenario, they could flake out. So you always want to know that you have somebody else in the back of your mind that could step into the role. You don't want to go through this process all over again. For our short Erringer, we decided to cast Bobbi Breckenridge in the lead role. She's a very, very talented actress. For the supporting, we were lucky to find Daniel Kusunoki, who will bring a lot to the role. There you have it, step three complete. Now, casting can be tricky, so hopefully you found this video useful. And remember, these are the actual actors that I'll be using when creating the short for this series. Subscribe so you can follow along and catch up if you've not seen the previous videos. Leave a comment, I'd love to know what you think, and sign up for the email newsletter. And remember, I'm just here to help make sci-fi. I kind of wanted to be in this, but Daniel's gonna be good.